I was sleeping face down on my wife at the time. And I guess that accordion player started up and I could hear that music. And then the cat commenced to wail and squall and lament like a stuffed buzzard. And I guess, well, partly awoke, but still in the midst of my dream, you see. Next thing I know is my wife informed me I shot the cat.
It's a sad story there, Birch.
Well, I was philosophical about it. I feel like at least one of us didn't have to listen to the damn recording. And it could have been worse. I could have shot my wife. Be no fun sleeping face down on a cat.
I expect not.
You know, I've never been able to catch up with that accordion player. It's often mysterious how he disappears. It's kind of spooky. But then again, it's nice when it stops. I mean, the peace and quiet makes you appreciate the silence. I guess that's what music is for. Well, that's kind of like having a clap. It comes and goes, but it ain't entirely ever gone. You know, Wyatt, I had a dream last night. You and I were dead. We were lying up there on the big hill. We were in our coffin side by side. And we were talking to one another to pass the time, which we had a lot of. And I says to you, I said, Wyatt, what's it smell like to be dead? And you says to me, you said, Virgil, well, hell, you ought to know better than I do. You've been dead a lot longer than I have. I said, well, I can't smell no more. My nose is all clogged. I thought in my dream if I had a pipe cleaner, I might be able to unclog it. Then I got to figuring, well, maybe my nose just fell off. I can still hear some coyotes, somebody playing the damn accordion. But what I really missed the most was being able to smell my feet again.
Smelt your feet, Virgil. That ain't worth worrying about.
Well, you're probably right. Also in my dream, they were these here prairie doves, and they were digging in my esophagus.
Virgil.
Yeah.
Shut up, Virgil.
Okay. So you really lost the itch to move?
Virgil, I hear somebody coming.
Why? I don't know how you do that.
It's a hell of a lot easier with your mouth shut, Birch.
Well, I never tried that. It ain't him, is it? Shit. It's him, ain't it? I was kind of hoping he'd be dead by now.
Yeah, me too.
Any of you boys need a dentist?
Howdy, Doc.
You look pretty damn stupid sitting in a rocking chair, Wyatt.
Doc, I thought you was dead.
Yeah, well, me too.
Virgil? Howdy, Doc. Where you been?
I don't exactly remember.
Stay for supper?
Well, I was hoping you'd say that. Ain't nobody can cook like your Mattie. You are still with Mattie, aren't you, Wyatt?
Can't seem to get rid of her. Hey, Matt, we got one more for supper!
The hell we do! You tell that Morgan Earp, he better teach Blondie how to cook. I can't be feeding your whole damn family all the damn time.
Hello, Mandy.
I ain't feeding him. I didn't let that man set foot in my damn house. What the hell's he doing here anyway? I thought he was dead.
Well, he ain't. Not yet. He's gonna eat supper with us.
White? That man ain't nothing but trouble. He's just gonna get you into some sort of lethal mess again. We have a nice place here, and we don't need no filthy, crooked, no good, gambling scum bucket to come in here and mess everything up, so you just get rid of him. Because he ain't setting foot in my house, and he sure as hell ain't touching my blackberry cobbler!
Ooh, you are as lovely as ever, Mandy.
Horseshit.
I think I might be in love with that woman, Wyatt.
Water?
But every now and then I get the feeling she don't return my affections. never remember you giving too much care about your looks.
We got elections around here, Doc, and folks are already mighty suspicious of us, Earps, because there's a bunch of us, and they heard about Dodge and other places you and I was associated with in the past, and we kind of descended on them and took over. We just can't go off making trouble.
I wasn't planning on making any trouble, Wyatt.
I know that, Doc.
You know, on second thought, I'm not nearly as hungry as I thought I was.
Now, Doc, come on. Just get back over and sit down. We just gotta be more careful than the old days. Can't go off shooting wild anymore, expect to get away with it. Just keep your temper around here, Doc. Go easy. Hell, any place I squat, you can squat, you know that, Doc.
You sure about that?
Of course I'm sure.
Well, you changed your mind, you let me be the first to know, so I'm not surprised.
Not gonna change my mind, Doc. Come on, sit down. So you finally got rid of Kate?
Well, I've got hopes anyway. I think I shook her somewhere around Denver. But you never can tell with that woman. She's kind of like a fungus. She just keeps popping up everywhere.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
No, you do not. Mattie is not a disease. She's a good girl. Kate, on the other hand, has got a head screwed on halfway crooked and can damn near beat me at arm wrestling.
I like Kate. Always like Kate.
Oh, I'll trade you.
I don't like her that much.
Please tell me you boys ain't got so respected when you gave up drinking and gambling.
Shit, I've got to get away from that woman somehow.
Ooh, Mr. Earp, are we having problems?
No, it's nothing much.
Her name's Josie.
Virgil, shut up.
You know what? That's twice today you told me to shut up.
I'm sorry, I lost my head.
Does Mattie know about him?
No.
Yep.
Virgil!
You gonna tell me to shut up again, what?
No, I was gonna tell you and Doc I don't like my private affairs discussed on the front porch.
All right, fair enough, fair enough. Josie, who?
Mattie, you're almost done with supper? Or are you gonna wait till we die to feed the funeral guests?
I ain't serving nothing to no dirty, crooked, gambling, batshit pig of a half-assed damn duchess at my table!
Wyatt, you know I love a woman can turn a phrase.
Mattie, you better get that dinner on the table before I come in there and beat you till you look like a blueberry pudding.
You only one finger on me, Wyatt Earp, and I will take this frying pan and
yelling and gatherings give me indigestion. I ain't even that yet. All we need now is a damn cake to show up.
I know I find you here, you damn
dog. Oh, I'm gonna go sit in the outhouse. You boys let me know what's up.
You thought you got rid of me, didn't you?
Why, Kate, how very serendipitous. I was afraid you were dead.
What the hell you mean running off on me like that?
Hey, I left you a note. Did you not get my note?
What I get was stuck with a $400 hotel bill. That's what I get.
Well, gee, Kate, that must have taken you a long time to work off of. 50 cents a crowd? Oh!
What do you mean by that?
Hey, Doc, you want to go check out my saloon?
What? I think that's a great idea.
You tell me what you mean by that. No. You look at
me. Hey, Mattie!
What you mean.
We got urgent business in town. Don't wait for it.
What? Why don't you go running off with that, dirty son of a... Hi, Kate.
Hello, Mattie.
Wait, you going to chase after him?
No. My feet hurt. Besides, he not go far with Wyatt around. I think I just sit here and rest the spell.
We heard you was dead, Kate.
Wishful thinking on someone's part. How are you, Mattie?
Oh, I'm all right. I got me a house.
Looks like a nice one, too. You got windows and everything.
It is. It's real nice. So you and Doc is still together, huh?
You call this together? Life gets rough, mess he leave behind. Say good riddance. Then I get to miss him, the son of a bitch. Sooner or later, I find him. It's not hard. He's leaving pretty clear trail. Then I get him a little sober. Never advisable to get Doc entirely sober. Then life okay till Doc get itchy. Life get rough, and but things are good for you, Doc. No?
Yeah. I don't know. No.
Same old thing.
It seems like he finally wants to settle down, Kate. He really does like it here. Got all involved in the town and everything, and politics. He's not like Doc. He always wanted to belong someplace. I just thought everything was going to work out all right.
Sounds good to me.
Except I think he's got a girl in town.
Yeah. Hell, Mattie, you can't have everything.
I don't want everything. Just don't want to share him with no other woman.
You know who she is?
Yeah, think so.
Then why don't you shoot her? Go on. You don't have to kill her. Just plug her on. Shoot her in the ass.
I missed you, Kate.
I could shoot her if it mattered that much.
I can't do that. I'm not that sort of person. And that is what's wrong with everything these days. Everybody having guns and such. Hate that.
Mattie, when you live in the big sty, sometimes you got to root around the slot with the rest of us hogs or you die. It's not pretty, it's just the way it is.
Kate, you have got to get Doc out of here, or he's gonna get Wyatt in trouble again. He never means to, but he always does. And Wyatt just can't resist him. I'm tired of moving around all the time and not belonging no place. I like it here.
I'd be trying to get Doc to go back to Denver. Thought we could settle down and have some more. He could run the car to the liquor, and I would take care of the girls. We could have a peaceful and respectable life. Whatever time he's got left. And I don't think that's much, Mattie. Mattie, you should see the stuff he coughed up. From his lung, it damn up. I don't even know what half of it is. He could have a few good years if he could just take care of himself. But he don't. I feel like an idiot chasing that man all the hell over the place. But he always glad to see me. Deep down. Give me something to do with my life.
Well, if you can get me back to Denver, or Santa Fe, or any place but here, I'd be mighty obliged to you.
I think on it. There ought to be some way to make that man see sense. You want me to shoot that girl for you, Mattie?
No. No, I want you to come inside and have some supper. It seems the only person I have to serve is myself, and there's plenty, so.
Well, don't worry. If it don't move, I eat it.
Come on, then.
Matt, when I see you, I remember what real folks is supposed to be.
I don't feel real, okay?
Sometimes Wyatt looks at me, it's like he's looking right through me. Like I wasn't even there. Just spooks me right out.
But such a smart man. Wyatt awful damn stupid.
Well, me too. Would you like to see my house?
I would love to.
Right this way. Watch your step. This is my parlor.
Escape, all right. Oh, now this easy and quiet.
way she got here, Wyatt, I could die a very happy death here.
Doc, I want you to meet my girl, Lonnie. Lonnie, this here's Doc Holliday. The one me and Wyatt would be better.
You don't look about mean and nasty.
Oh, I am, though. I'm even meaner and nastier than Wyatt is saying.
Can you just stay away from my boy? I like him the way he is. Nice and innocent.
Oh, don't you worry that, sweetheart. I don't think Wyatt would let me corrupt his little brother too often much. If I might want to corrupt this little thing here, Wyatt hadn't beaten me to the punch. What's your name, sweetheart?
Josie, and what has been to the punch?
Yes, well, Dr. Holliday's celebrated foot and mouth disease strikes again.
Well, then you could prep me some other time, Doc.
I seriously doubt that.
Anybody here want to corrupt me?
Oh, sweetheart, you look like you could corrupt me.
I resent that.
Well, then there's still one. Hey, why don't you buy us a drink? I ain't found me a group of suckers yet.
If I buy you a drink, Doc, it'll be the last time I do.
If you buy me a drink, it'll be the last time you have to, Wyatt. As long as I can find myself a car again.
Don't cheat in my saloon, Doc.
Oh, you don't cheat, do you, Doc?
I never cheat anybody I can beat, and I can beat everybody sooner or later. I simply listen to the cards, and the cards beat everybody by and by. I just kindly sift through the carnage. Besides, most of these damn yahoos get so nervous, they fold up pretty quick, and if that don't work, well, I just cough in their face.
Josie, where'd you say you was going?
San Francisco.
San Francisco? What's a girl from a reasonably civilized place like San Francisco doing in a godforsaken place like this? No offense, Wyatt. It's awful nice for a bunch of sticks and mud in the middle of hell, but it's not San Francisco.
I like it here. I like the wind, though. They're bigger than other men, and I like them.
I bet you do.
We was in the middle of a national tour of Gilbert Sullivan's high-class favorites. But then to the general low-taste and lack of coup in this here part of nowhere, we became financially depressed somewhere west of Squatier, Arizona. Mr. Earp was kind enough to take us in.
Okay, then he's okay.
That's your bucket of worms, not mine. Is that fair?
Well, that sounds perfectly fair.
Okay. Nice to meet you, Doc. Hope you enjoy your stay in Tombstone. Bye, Josie. Careful these plants and flowers here. They got their eyes on you. If that were my girl, Wyatt, I wouldn't let no cowboys look at her like that.
Hey, Johnny, is you talking about us behind our back again? Why don't you do something useful and send that Josie on over here?
Come on, Josie. We like you.
Hey, Josie, come on over here, girl.
Hey, Josie, you want to see another trick?
What kind of trick, Doc?
This is how you make a dentist disappear.
He sure moves fast for a sick man.
I know he was here. I smell him. There. There is that damn near-sighted snake. I know he was here. Hello, Morgan.
Howdy, Kate.
Interesting fellow, that, Doc. Wyatt, what
still bleeding, which means I ain't dead yet. And in itself is a source of some amazement. Shit. Go away!
It's Josie, Doc. I brought you some breakfast.
I don't eat breakfast. Go away! I'm shaving!
Can I come in and watch?
Not unless you want to see a man cut his own throat.
Now that might be kind of exciting. Come on, Doc. This tray's heavy.
The door is not locked.
Man like you should lock his door, Doc.
Yeah, well, I like to keep all my escape routes open.
You sure you don't want something to eat?
Why don't you go get Wyatt something to eat?
He went off early this morning. Something about a stagecoach robbery.
Yeah, is he committing it or investigating it?
I like you. You're funny.
A lot of folks I shot thought I was a regular riot.
I thought you slept mornings.
That accordion playing sadist kept me up all night. When I find out who that is, I'm going to kill the son of a bitch. And whoever the hell invented the polka, I'm going to kill him too. Why don't you just get the hell out of here?
Why don't you like me?
Well, I don't think anything about you one way or another.
Well, you liked me before you found out I was Wyatt's girl.
Is there some law around here that says I gotta like all Wyatt's girlfriends? So many damn laws in this place, I can't keep up with them.
What have you got against me?
Oh, sweetheart, I ain't got nothing against you.
Would you like to? I just want all Wyatt's friends to like me, is all. So what can I do to get you to like me better?
Go back to San Francisco.
Well, that's not a very nice thing to say.
Well, if you don't want to hear the answers, don't ask the questions.
And why should I go back to San Francisco?
Wyatt's got a wife.
They're not married and they've got no papers. Just where the hell do you get off looking down your nose at me? You're a damn murmuring, crooked poker player.
Look, kid, I wouldn't press my luck if I was you. I ain't had me a drink all morning. It is generally not a good idea to press your luck with me when I'm sober.
What does it matter who Wyatt sleeps with anyway? Me or her, what's the difference?
Maddie's a nice girl.
Well, so am I. I am, and that woman's got no more claim on him than I do, or that Kate Elder's got on you for that matter, so get off your damn high horse.
Shit, you made me cut myself again.
Well, good. Bleed to death. What's the matter, Doc?
Well, you don't smell like a nice girl.
And what do I smell like?
You smell like a French whore.
I'm a nice girl. A very nice girl. You just don't know how nice I am.
Then why didn't you stay in San Francisco?
And why didn't you stay wherever the hell you came from?
Georgia.
And why didn't you stay there?
Well, I'm not a nice girl.
You're not so tough. If you want something and don't go get it, that's your fault. That's what I think. So if you want something, go.
And just what is it that you want right now, Josie? Careful there, Doc. She'll catch her throat. Didn't anybody teach you how to knock in school?
I must have been sick that day. Hi there, Josie. I see you're a dress for church.
Why'd you bring this walking pile of shit into my room before breakfast? Are you trying to ruin my appetite?
We're here on business, Doc.
You've got business here in my room.
Tell him, Wyatt. Just shut your damn mouth, all right?
What's the problem, Wyatt?
We gotta arrest you, Doc.
For what? Shaving?
For stagecoach robbing and murder.
Oh, donkey snot.
It's true, Doc.
Yeah, and what evidence do you have?
Oh, we got great evidence. You ain't gonna like this one, Doc. Hey, evidence! Come on in here! This here is our star witness, Miss Kate Elder, and she's gonna testify against you, Doc. Says she heard you planning the whole thing. She says that you were gonna
get... You better say your prayers, Kate!
Now, Doc, you don't want to do that. You're just
Get blood all over the place and have to change rooms.
Is that my friend, Wyatt Earp, with his hand on me like that? Is that my friend, Wyatt Earp, whom I damn near got my sexual equipment shot off for in Dodge City when nobody else would give him the time of day?
Doc, just gotta put you in jail for a little while, till we get everything straightened out. Promise we'll get you out soon. We gotta warn, we gotta do things the right way.
Yeah, well, that ain't how you and me used to do things, Wyatt.
We got laws now, Doc.
I can see that. Fine, Wyatt, have it your way. It's your ball game. I can tell you this. When I get out of jail, I better not see Kate Elder anywhere near where I am, or she's gonna be the best ventilated woman in Arizona. Oh, Johnny. You may go. Why don't you put on some damn clothes? Come on, chicken shit, just stay downwind from me. How the hell am I supposed to get into the jail if you don't go and unlock the cell? Jeez, this town sure is safe with you on the job. I don't know about this, Wyatt. I just don't know.
I was just doing my civic duty, Doc.
Wyatt, you better shove something in that woman's mouth or she's gonna have to find her way down the stairs without a head.
I want to talk to you.
I didn't do anything.
Not you. Why would I want to talk to you? I want to talk to Kate.
Well, I don't want to talk to you.
I don't give a damn what you want.
You cannot threaten witness, Wyatt. Is the law.
You know that Doc Holliday didn't rob no damn stagecoach.
I hear him plan. I did. I swear. I'm not afraid of you, Wyatt. Not much, anyway. Just mind your own damn business. This is between me and Doc.
Not anymore, it ain't. You made it my business when you drug that little fart Johnny Behan into this and told him that Doc robbed the stagecoach. And you gotta tell the truth.
I tell the truth. Now leave me alone or I have you arrested, too. Why don't you put your own house in order? Go home to Mattie. Forget about this little slut. If you will excuse me, I have an interview to give with Mr. Plume of Tombstone Death. I have responsibility to the public, you know.
Sit there like a snake that swallowed a rock. I wish you would just yell at me. Doc didn't rob a stagecoach, did he?
I don't think so.
You're not sure?
I'm pretty sure.
Wyatt, I was just...
I don't want to hear it.
I was just lonesome and I wanted somebody to talk to, and if you're not off chasing stagecoach robbers and bushwhackers, you're home with that woman.
Her name is Maddie.
I know what her name is.
You can do what you please.
What pleases me is being with you, but I don't have to share you with somebody else. Maybe you should have to start sharing me too, so you know what it feels like.
I've got my job to do.
This isn't about your job, it's about Maddie. When I took up with you, I stopped from trying to be him, but you're still going on with Maddie. That's not fair.
Never said it was. You don't have to do anything you don't want. I'm just going to mind my own business, okay?
Just, why don't you talk about this?
You do what you want.
Fine, Wyatt, I will. I'll do as I please. I mean it. I will.
You do that.
Fine.
Fine.
Damn you, Wyatt! And what the hell kind of stupid name is Earp anyway?
Well, it'll get them off the Jim Earps is just like that.
I'm gonna ask Doc about it. He knows it better than I do. Doc's smart.
He's not smart enough to get away from Kate.
Polishing the doorknobs. Mind your own damn business.
Okay. Don't have to bite my head off.
There's someone who wants to see you.
I don't talk to any more cowboys.
This ain't a cowboy.
I don't want to talk to any more men at all. I'm sick of men.
This ain't a man. Come on in, Mattie.
Situation is. See, Wyatt was married once before. Yeah, he didn't tell you that, did he? He's different then. Not so wild, I think. She died real young, and he was real young too, and Wyatt just kind of went crazy after that. He got in all kinds of bad trouble. But he got himself straightened out, went to work for the law. But he's still got these angry places in him, and if you touch one, well, you gotta pay. And part of him, deep down, but still grieving, don't care much whether or not he lives or dies. That's what makes him a good marshal. He met Doc, Dodge City, or Deadwood before that, I don't know. Doc saved his life somehow. But I don't think that's why they're friends. I think Doc is the only even half-educated, smart person that Wyatt's ever had the chance to talk to understand the dead places in him. Because Doc's got the same dead parts. You know what I mean?
I think so.
Not that they talk much. Some nights they'll spend whole evening sitting on the porch and never make a sound. Makes them feel not so lonesome, I think. See, Wyatt can't open up much to me because he thinks I'm not very smart. And he thinks I'm not his real wife, the one who died. He thinks that if he gets to liking me too much, well, I'll go up and die on him like she did. So he talks to Doc. He knows Doc's gonna die, so that don't matter. But when Doc ain't around, it's just the two of us. Like before you came to town. Wyatt would give just as much of himself to me as he's capable of. Sometimes at night he'd give me a little piece of his soul, too. He'd be nice to me. I don't know if in the dark he could pretend I was her or what, but I could feel him sort of relaxing with me, and I thought, with Doc off someplace, maybe even dead by then, and us get settled in here, and Virgil and Adam's real sweet. Morgan's kind of wild, but he never mean no harm. I thought everything was going to work out all right. you showed up. You're so damn beautiful, you get to remind him of her again. And he feels guilty about that, so he takes it out on me. And then that son of a bitch, duck hound, you show up and make everything worse because a part of Wyatt really does want to settle down and stop running. There's a war inside of him, and it hurts me to see it because I want to comfort him. But he won't let me because he feels so bad about you, but he can't quit you because you remind him of her, and he hates you for that, so... I ain't asking you to give him up. I ain't asking you for anything. I just wanted you to know how it was between Wyatt and me. Because I knew Wyatt couldn't. Himself. Just wanted you to know.
Mattie, I don't know what you want me to say.
I want to hear it anyway. You ain't had life too hard yet, Josie. You're still really young. You still think life's gonna work out all right somehow. As I know it ain't. Just trying to hold on to what I got for a while. Partly for why. Partly for me. You sure are a beautiful girl, Josie.
Mattie!
Hey, Wyatt?
What?
I have my gun back for just a moment.
What for?
So I can shoot this son of a bitch that's been snoring in my ear for the past 3 days. Worse than the damned accordion player, I'm beginning to wish you'd just go ahead and hang me. Hey, Wyatt.
What?
Can you get that deck card for me? Yourself. The Queen of Diamonds. I have always been in love with the Queen of Diamonds. You know why I love them all. Queen of Diamonds, I love her the best. The Queen of Hearts, well, she's a sweet, gentle soul. Queen of Clubs, she's a melancholy type girl. And Queen of Spades, she's a witch girl. She will cut your throat in bed, but she will make you very happy first. But the Queen of Diamonds, no, she's smart. Lips are red, she's got them eyes that see right through you. Body that just makes you want to run your fingers all up and down. Yes, sir, I have always been in love with the Queen of Diamonds.
I like fat women. Bigger, but better. The more they look like a cow, the better I like them.
Why let me shoot this son of a bitch so at least you can hang me for something I did?
That'd be nice to him, Doc.
Nice? Hell, he smells like a sack of shit.
I'm telling you, Doc.
Why, what are you doing in a place like this? You don't belong here. Unless you may run off to California or even someplace civilized. You don't belong in a fart factory like this. This place has all the charm of a mortuary.
Can't do that, Doc. You gotta stand trial.
For what? I ain't done nothing, and you know it.
Doesn't matter what I know.
Well, it used to. Tell you what, Wyatt, you wanna go and get all respectable-like on us? Why don't you just, go on and marry Mattie? Make an honest woman out of her. Stop all that rubbing around with that little whore over the Oriole.
Doc?
Ooh, Marshal Earp. Do I detect a small threat in your voice?
Maybe you just want her for yourself.
Which one?
I like to put my nose
doing it in the god-awfulest shithole in the entire West. Why, I'm just fine. How the hell are you?
I bring some good food for that desperado look out there. Fried chicken. Doc never could keep his hands off a nice, soft breast for all the money in the world. You can just throw it to him through the bars, one piece at a time. Oh! Wyatt, you can't. What are you doing? You cannot leave me here with him. He may kill me.
It's kind of what I'm planning on. Then we can hang him fair and square. Now I'm going to go take a leak and smoke a cigar, and by the time I get back, I want this all settled between the two of you, all right?
Wyatt, you leave me in here with this woman, and one of us is going to be dead before your piss hits the ground.
Maybe you'll kill each other and save us the expense of a trial.
Well, you might as well hang me, too. I'm just no damn good. That's what my mother used to tell me. She used to say, Wimpy. He called me Wimpy, but my name is Julius. She used to say, Julius, yeah, Wimpy, you're as useless as tits on a board.
Will you just shut the hell up? Just shut the hell up!
Testify against me by marrying him. He's right, Wyatt.
Seems like I heard that once.
Come on, Wyatt.
No, Doc.
This is a damn conspiracy.
You mind if the judge marries you, Kate? Somebody shot the preacher.
I don't care, as long as it's legal. I want to be a respectable woman.
Hey, Judge, get out. Better than sitting around here yapping about it.
Wyatt, you cannot do this to me. This man man's under arrest. He accused of murder and robbery.
Hey, Doc, did you rob that stagecoach?
Not that I can remember.
Good enough for me. Let's go.
Coward. Coward. Coward, you get back here! Violence her out of the competition. I do it all the time. Her
I ain't got no gun. What's good?
you and go to that.
Don't you come no near me, Virgil.
I'm not gonna bother you.
Damn right you're not. You come one step closer, I'm gonna shoot you.
Oh, so you do have a gun.
Now, I ain't said that.
Well, how in the hell are you gonna shoot me? You gonna shoot me with that bridge in your midsection?
I might have a gun.
But you're not shooting.
No, you ain't sure.
If we ain't sure, we're gonna assume you got guns. And if you got guns, we gotta disarm you. And if you resist, we gotta shoot you.
Why?
Because we got guns.
Oh. Can I just take 1 minute and go back behind the photography studio? Just for 1 second, please.
Just don't move, Frank!
I'm trying not to move, Tom!
I tell you what, I'm just gonna shoot somebody here in a second.
Take it easy, Doc.
Did I forget to go feed my horse, Billy?
You're a daisy if you do.
I'm just gonna go feed my horse.
Don't you move.
I know.
You move and I'll shoot you. Hell, I'll shoot you and the horse you rode in on.
Damn it, Wyatt, I'm gonna go to the other house too.
Shotgun and Josie doesn't hardly have any clothes on.
Maddie, go.
You don't get to talk to me like that. I ain't your dog, and I'll do as I please.
Maddie.
Don't touch her.
Josie, will you just stay out of this? You want her to kill you or something?
Maybe she's got a right to be mad. Maybe she's mad at the wrong person. You're the one that's doing the dirt.
I ain't doing a damn
thing. The hell you're not. You think you can have it both ways, but you can't, Wyatt. You need to make a choice here. It's not fair to either one of us.
Why don't you keep your nose out of this, you little trollop? I don't need you on my side, and I don't need you feeling sorry for me.
I'm not on your side. I think Wyatt just needs to stop being such a weasel and make a choice with us.
Will you women just stop nagging me for 2 minutes? Old man Clem's brought charges against us. We're gonna have to go to court.
When?
Just as soon as we can get the judge sober enough to sit up in a chair.
That's stupid. You were all deputized. Aren't you deputized, Doc?
Well, shit, I don't know.
Doesn't make any sense.
It's the law, sweetheart. It's not supposed to make sense.
Ike says that we provoked a fight. I don't know what he says. It's a bunch of garbage. But I can't be worried about you two women blowing holes in each other, all right?
You can prosecute a marshal for doing his duty, can't you?
Blowing people's heads off. That's his duty.
And what the hell were you just about to do to me?
You know, you got a point there, Josie. You're wrong, Kate. You can't beat an animal by being an animal. Even if you win, you lose. I don't want to be like these animals. That's their game. It ain't mine. I don't want to shoot her or anyone else.
Could be.
I'm so tired of all this killing.
So am I.
Are you?
Yes, I am.
What are you going to do about Maddie?
Let me think about it.
Do you still love her?
That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
It's the truth, Wyatt. I'm not going to put up with this anymore.
You don't want me? Fine. That's up to you.
It's not that I don't want you, it's that you don't seem to know what you want, and you're driving me crazy.
Will you just stop nagging me for 2 minutes? Christ! You want a man, but you won't let him be who he is. You want him to be strong, and then you spend all your time making him weak. You want him to be perfect. You take no greater pleasure than pointing out where he ain't. You want him to make a choice for you? He does. You take up with somebody else. If I had any sense at all, I'd take Virgil Morgan and Doc and go live in the middle of the desert with a bunch of Indian women. Those Indian women would just be the same as you are. The only real solution is to blow my brains out.
Wait,
out the damn gunfire, you shithead!
Sorry, Judge.
good.
Oh, I'm sorry, I lost my head. Now, tell us what happened at the gun at the corral.
Well, I was down there with my dead brother Billy, and we was unarmed, and we was down there in the alleyway down there by the photographical studio, and we was down there with our dead friends, Tom and Frank McLeod, also unarmed. And Frank, he had to go to the outhouse, and we was busy getting ready to go back to the ranch on account of we was going to study up on the Bible, because we were real religious folks. And then Frank had to go to the outhouse, and then that son of a bitch Wyatt Earp come down there with his crazy murdering bastard friend Doc Holliday and a whole bunch of them other damn vicious Earp brothers, and they ambushed us with shotguns and blow the living shit out of everybody down there and killed everybody dead in the table.
You ain't dead, Ike.
Well, I ain't been feeling too damn good.
You meant it not to get killed.
Well, Wyatt, I reckon God spared me so that I could come up here and tell the God's honest gospel truth about what happened.
You think that's what it was? Do you, Ike?
Well, God's ways is entirely mysterious to the frail mind of his mortal creature.
And you say none of you boys had any guns?
No, sir, not a one.
None of you boys had guns, and who shot Virgil and Morgan?
I don't know. I don't know that nobody shot them. Not to my recollection, no one.
If nobody shot them, how did they get all them bullet holes?
You're our object.
Oh, Johnny, sit down and shut up. I answer the question.
Oh, would you mind repeating the question?
If nobody had any guns, how did Virgil and Moore get all them freaking bullet holes?
Well, I believe maybe God might have put them in. And in his mysterious, mysterious strangeness. Hell, maybe they fell on the gun when they fainted, passed out in all excitement. Or hell, maybe Wyatt and Doc shot them. Or they could have shot each other when it was in some kind of rage over one of these scarlet people.
That story stinks worse than ear to ear.
Well, you don't smell too damn good yourself, Judge.
Well, I tell you what. Let's make everybody happy and get this thing over with. You boys was down there resisting arrest, and some of you had guns, and you put bullet holes in Virgin Moore, and everybody knows that Ike planted the damnedest skunk of a lying jackass in town. Case dismissed.
Why?
choices left in my life, but you do it so
I am not going to stand here and listen to life advice from some damn drunken son. You...
I have to tell you about this girl back home named Mattie. She's a real sweet girl. In fact, she and I were going to be married.
You
don't laugh. It's true. Sweet girl. Except my daddy had other plans for me. He shipped me off to Baltimore for a dental school. Except the only thing I got out of that entire experience was a large set of pliers and a fatal dose of consumption. Doctor said I had 6 months to live. Maybe longer if I headed out west where the air was dry, so I boarded a train and said goodbye to Mattie and my folks. Headed out west. And just for giggles, on the ride out here, I decided to drink myself damn near into a coma. Hell if it was, I didn't die. I don't know if the liquor pickled my innards or what, but here I am. I soon found out I was pretty good at playing cards. I could make a decent living at gambling. Only problem being that these yahoos get pretty damn bent out of shape when you start taking their money. So I started practicing with my guns, just for protection. But I was awful at it. You see, my eyes aren't too good at a distance. But the only way to stay safe in them saloons is to go heels, so the first time that some behemoth, twice as big as I did, got all riled up, I just walked up till I was 1 foot away from him, and I said, draw. You see, in most gunfights, the only people that get hurt is innocent bystanders. If you shoot the person you're actually aiming at, it's probably because your bullet ricocheted off a frying pan and bounced all around the room. Most folks can't shoot close to damn, but standing 1 foot away from each other, there wasn't no chance that either one of us was going to miss. And so this fellow looks at me and his eyes get big as pie pans. Turns all quiet and doughy. And in that moment, I knew I had it. So I unleashed on him with every curse word I knew, even made up some right there on the spot that to this day, I'm not exactly sure what they mean. That jackass looked at me and he said, "Mister, you're crazy." And then he turns tail and runs. And that, Mattie, is how I earned my reputation as a gunslinger. Pure cowardice. You see, that man is not Wyatt's friend. But I am. Mattie, you've got to give him a choice. What you're doing here, you're just pushing him right into her lap.
You can sit here, talk decent to me like this. Why ain't you the master?
Because I don't want her around.
Why not? She loves you, Doc. She'd do anything for you.
I don't want some damn woman mooning around after me all the time. She just reminds me. She reminds me of what I cannot have. And she knows how it's going to end, and she's torturing the both of us. Me coughing up my lungs until there's absolutely nothing left, and her standing there watching. God never made a stupider woman in the history of the damn world. Go talk to Wyatt. Okay. Mattie, you've got to go talk to him before it's too late.
No! Why do I always gotta go to him? Why can't he ever come to me?
Doc, I got to cry. You might not think so, but
damn door. I'll shoot my way in. I've got enough. Oh, where the hell's my gun? I got it here a minute ago.
Why don't shoot?
What the hell you mean making me wait out in the hall? I'm in the whole band. I got stage coaches to rob.
Darling, it's 2:00 in the morning. What are you
doing? I know what time it is, sweetheart. Don't know what day it is, but I do know what time it is. Which is why I never wind my pocket watch.
Doc, Wyatt's not here.
I know why it's not here. He's downstairs, losing his damn money like the damn fool that he
what are you doing here?
Well, sweetheart. I didn't come here to play checkers. Come and get it. No, I have not yet begun to defile myself.
Stay up there, Doc.
What's the matter, sweetheart? You was all hot and bothered for me just the other day. Did you lose your nerve? All the tease and then the freeze?
Don't like some drunk busting into my room in the middle of the night.
Oh, and you are right, sweetheart, because I am a cad and a scoundrel, a louse and a flounder. And I humbly beg your
Jack, put me down! What the hell's gotten into you?
Well, sweetheart, I just got to thinking that it didn't make sense to waste a beautiful woman when she's willing to debase herself with the likes of me.
I've never seen you like this.
No, sweetheart, I generally save this kind of behavior for funerals and hangings or consummations.
Talk water back soon.
No, he won't. That poker game's gonna last all night. I know a long situation.
Maybe, but still, Doc, you can't be here.
Why is that, sweetheart? You know what? I have to tell you, you're the most beautiful woman I've ever seen before in my life.
I thought you didn't like me.
I don't see what that's got to do with anything.
Your mama always said beauty comes from within.
Your mama lied. Beauty comes from without. Shit comes from within. Tell me something, sweetheart. Why don't you tell me why girls like you get all hot and bothered for men like me? And why? Why don't you tell me that?
I'm attracted to dangerous men sometimes. That's true up to a point, but I also like women that have certain limits. I'm not sure you've got any.
It's death, for one. I am limited by death.
Yes, that's another attractive thing about you. You seem close to death.
Oh, not me. I'm in my prime.
You talk like these people and act like these people, but it seems to me like you're playing a part. You're an educated man, Doc. You've read books. You know things.
And a hell of a lot of good that's going to do me out here.
Why did you really come to my room tonight? Easy.
Well, I ain't got time for
Doc,
easy.
I can't.
Well, I ain't got time for much of
Doc,
anything.
Really.
Like a cigarette light? What about you, Joseph? I always like a cigarette afterwards. It tends to really cut the tension.
He's crazy. He's just drunk. You don't want to shoot him.
Why, make up your... Joseph, make up your damn mind. Either I was attacking you or I wasn't. And if I was attacking you, well, then the man has every right to shoot me. If I wasn't attacking you, well, then... You must have invited me in.
You just shut up, Tim, and I'm trying to say
something. Save your damn breath. Why don't they go shoot me? You look a lot more likely he gonna shoot you. But he probably ain't gonna shoot you. You see, Josie, me and you, we's the same kind of people. Ain't that right, Wyatt? She and I's just made for each other.
Wyatt! Dare you, you pastor! What the hell would you do that for?
Well, he's gone now, sweetheart. We're not going to fool around.
Just get the hell out of here after killing him.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry you couldn't.
I am sorry. I'm real sorry. You're not a bad girl. You're just too damn young and way too beautiful. But you will be just fine. I'm not worried about you one way or the other.
No.
You're gonna be just fine.
Damn you, you're a horrible, evil man! And I hope you don't die from it!
It's over.
I don't believe you.
Promise it's over. I'll leave this place, never think about it again. I'll get a nice quiet job and never have to come back here.
I want to believe you. I do, but Wyatt, I've been hurt by you.
They shot Virgil.
Who did?
I don't know. Clanton's, somebody. Nobody saw. He's okay. Just healing up from that gunfight. Somebody shot him in the back and left him for dead.
Well, what do you need to do?
Morgan wanted to ride out to town and shoot everybody inside. Hell, that was my first instinct, too. Hate comes easy when you get used to it. Then I thought about it. Ain't no end to it. We kill them and then they kill us. We kill them again until there's nobody left. I just want to end. But I need you to help me. See how old Virgil's doing. Son of a bitch is too stupid to die. We have to stop talking.
This town.
Looking better, Virgil. Still smart's my pee.
stupidity. You have no idea just how close you are to being shot clean through the head. I haven't slept in a week due to the unfortunate selection of cowboy favorites and polkas played by that accordion-playing sadist. If I ever find out who that is, I'm going to kill the son of a bitch. There's going to be pieces of accordion spread all over the desert from here to Salt Lake City, and pieces of accordion player attached to them.
You kill yourself with drink. We need to get out of here, and we need to get out of here now. Let's go back to Lee. We could have a baby. Would you like to have a little baby?
Would you just leave me the hell alone? You just shut up and leave me the hell alone? A baby.
Christ, a baby.
You be nice to me. I have you arrested. Again.
What?
Doc, you
gotta
help me.
What?
Doc, you gotta help me. I can't stand it.
You got a sock in your mouth. That's what's the matter.
I got a toothache. And Doc is the closest thing to a dentist in 500 miles. Doc, can you help me?
Will you just leave me the hell alone?
Judge, this here particular time, not the best time to bother Doc. He not in a real good mood today.
Well, I gotta do something. This tooth is killing me. I've even tried to play my accordion, which usually settles my nerves. Especially late at night with my insomnia and all, but it ain't helping none with this tooth.
Accordion.
Yeah, my accordion. It soothes my nerves, but it ain't helping none with this tooth. It's driving me to drink.
You are the accordion player.
Yeah. My mother taught me how to play back in Albany. She was engaged to this Italian banana salesman who unfortunately choked on a bag of pistachio nuts. Can you help me, Doc?
Oh, I'm going to help you, all right.
Hey, look, Doc. I think you ought to help this man, since you're the only dentist within 500 miles. I think you have an obligation to humanity and to your oath as a doctor to help this man. Doc, look on as a kind of a public service to the whole community.
Oh, yes. Public service. Kate, go get my bag.
Doc, I don't think you want
Kate! This man is in pain. We've got to put him out of his misery now. Go and get my bag.
Got that where you say.
Judge, why don't we have a seat here and see if we can't get you comfortable.
Thank you, Doc.
Let's see what... Isn't this lovely? It's like it was soaked up blood just fine. Let's tie this around your neck. We don't want to... get blood all over the floor or nothing, now do we?
Well, thank you, Doc, for this. Lord!
Oh, you have to excuse me, Your Honor. I'm kind of out of practice here, so you have to forgive me.
That's all right. I appreciate you doing this for me, Doc.
Oh, it's my pleasure, Your Honor. We want to make sure that you can get back to playing your accordion just as quick as possible. Ain't that right, Virgil?
Oh, yeah, we don't want you to miss any time playing your accordion.
Oh, well, that's real nice of you fellas.
Judge, I think you should wait for another time to do this.
No. The sooner we get this over with, the better.
Here you go, Doc.
Oh, thank you, Kay. Let's see what we got here. Very ironic. something to do. Virgil, why don't you look in there and tell me what you think? Virgil's my dental assistant. Uh-huh. So look over there.
Yeah, didn't have to look. Yep. Liver and onions.
No, not that, Virgil. Over here. Oh, that's his tongue. Not his tongue. The white thing in the back.
Doc, I don't mean to criticize your technique, but I'm getting a little dizzy here.
Judge, that could be the toothache, or it could be all that rot gut you suck down every day.
Now, wait a minute. Maybe I ought to just...
Judge, it is my professional opinion that if we can't tell which tooth is the offending one, well, we just gonna have to remove them all.
Well, just wait a minute here.
But don't worry, darling. That infected tooth, it ain't gonna be bothering you one bit after this, because the pain from having all them other ones yanked out is gonna take your mind right off of it.
I changed my mind. I want a second opinion.
Ooh, second opinion? How about you're the worst friggin' accordion player in the whole damn Western Hemisphere?
Now, Your Honor, this is the point where normally I would take a blunt object and bat my patients over the head so as to put them in a semi-unconscious state, but I'm going to skip that step for you today because I want you to feel every damn minute of this.
Just killed my brother, for Christ's sake. What am I supposed to do?
Why? If you do this, I ain't going with you no more. I mean it. If you do this, I ain't coming with you.
I'm going to have to leave town after I settle this particular score anyway. If you want, you can come then.
I won't come.
What?
I think I might come along with you. I don't know when you boys might need a dentist.
Come on.
I'll show you.
Baby, all right?
Yeah. You're really not gonna go with him?
No, I'm done.
You change your mind?
No. And if you don't, I will. You think he'd take you now?
If he comes back when I'm not here, he'll take me.
Yes. I expect he will. You don't let it happen like that? Why don't you fight for what you want? I don't want to fight. I don't believe in that. Don't matter if you believe in it. It's true. It might be true, but it ain't right. Life just made up burn. Don't mean shit. You know that. It's never gonna end, is it? They're just gonna keep on killing till everybody's dead. Did you see the look on her face? The hate there! She got damn good reason to hate. So did you. Yeah.
Come now, Mattie. That is not
good. Leave me alone.
What? Not want that, Mattie.
Get away from me! Don't touch me! Just get away, all of you! You're all part of it! You worship it. You worship the danger of it. It makes you feel excited! You worship heroes! And they use you! And you let them! Because you worship violence! Do you know what a hero is? A hero is a butcher. They butcher people. You have to be a good butcher or else you're not a hero. I have seen God's world, and it is one big butcher shop. You worship butchers! Get away from me.
Leave her alone, Sassy. Leave her alone.
Thank you.
steal.